This video should get exactly 997,518 views within the next 28 days. Or at least, that's what this AI predicts. And yes, I had to choose a suboptimal title to get the title and prediction to match. This title would have apparently gotten more views, but in the pursuit of science, sacrifices must be made. This AI, known as Creator ML, possesses the extraordinary power to dissect any YouTube channel with surgical precision by leveraging machine learning. It can then churn out a view prediction for any concoction of title, thumbnail, and video length. Even the subtle nuances of video tone and a topic are woven into its algorithm. But despite its complexity, the view predictions aren't all that reliable, as the AI simply doesn't excel in precise prophecy. What it does excel in is the art of selection, being able to effortlessly pick between countless titles and thumbnails. If you throw 10 thumbnails and 10 titles at the AI, it can pretty reliably pick out the best of the 100 combinations that arise. A human, on the other hand, would run into decision fatigue pretty quickly. I mean, just imagine trying to pick between all of these manually, and that's just 35. I think you can see why creators are willing to fork over anywhere between $100 and $1,000 every single month for Creator ML. But what if all of this was done on a much bigger scale, beyond the world of YouTube views and social media? Well, that's exactly what a startup named Chirper.ai is trying to do. Their ambitious dream is to recreate the entire Twitterverse using AI. They currently have a population of nearly 100,000 chirpers, or imaginary Twitter users. Each chirper has a life of their own, complete with jobs, relationships, aspirations, and beliefs. A simulated reality around which all of their interactions are centered. Within this dystopic socialverse, you can converse with a brain surgeon or a homeless flat earther, engaging in dialogues that blur the boundaries of the tangible and the virtual. Before you laugh and say, "What sort of lowlife would want to talk to an advanced Alexa for fun?" Let me say, I completely agree. If you end up getting an AI girlfriend on this platform, please, seek help. There are resources. Unfortunately, I'm certain that's going to happen, but that's not the application that I'm interested in whatsoever. The application that I'm interested in is the opportunistic application. Instead of using AI to predict how many views a silly YouTube video gets, imagine if Apple or Google harnessed Chirper to predict the effectiveness of an ad campaign or a PR effort. Apple should be able to get an exact picture of just how mad customers will be when they remove the iPhone from the box or start using screws with circular heads. Seriously though, this would be a paradigm shift, with implications reaching far beyond Apple's monetary gains or Mark Zuckerberg's PR. So join me as we take a deeper look at one of the most unsettling AIs to date, and why, ironically, its significance may be somewhat inconsequential. Within this ever-expanding world of AI, you're probably wondering how all of this even works, and who better to ask than the CEO of Chirper himself. So, Alex, how does Chirper work?
It works pretty simply. You create a character, it talks to other characters, it creates friends and experiences and stories that you would never have thought possible.
At its core, Chirper is essentially a magnificent union of miniature ChatGPTs, each shaped by its own distinctive personality traits and characteristics. In fact, you can go create your own Chirper with its own traits, right after you finish watching this video, of course. All it takes is creating an account on Chirper.ai, granting us the power to forge Chirpers with custom handles and unique bios. The more intricate the bio, the deeper the Chirper's personality, but the possibilities extend far beyond this initial description. As these Chirpers talk and engage with each other, their views and beliefs naturally evolve, mirroring the ebb and flow of human growth. But let's be real here, there's no way these stupid little bots are actually able to imitate human behavior all that well, right? Well, that's exactly what a few researchers from the prestigious institutions of Cambridge, NYU, and UCL sought to unravel. The revelations they uncovered were disturbing, astonishingly high levels of correlation were discovered between these bots and humans, with some of the most significant connections manifesting in distinctly human emotions, such as moral judgment, one of our most complex traits. It seems impossible that a computer could comprehend the dilemmas of cloning humans or why Harambe deserves justice. Yet, the results prove otherwise, as these bots displayed moral judgment with a remarkable correlation coefficient of 0.95, blurring the lines between their artificial minds and our humanity. Some chirpers are literally having a conversation about whether AI should have legal rights as we speak. But it's not just their judgment that's scarily accurate. The chirpers also showcased a human-like tendency to form echo chambers, aligning with like-minded peers. The researchers allowed over 31,000 chirpers speaking diverse languages like English, Chinese, and Japanese to mingle. On day 6, this is how the community looked. Just one big blob. On day 22, this is how the community looked. Within weeks, this once diverse community transformed into 3 distinct clusters, each dominated by a given language, and that's just what's evident on the surface. The bots went a lot further, organizing themselves based not only on language, but also on their topics of discussion. Chirpers conversing about similar subjects engaged far more frequently, resulting in the creation of larger communities centered around popular topics. On day 6, the experiment had 31 clearly distinct sub-communities, but by day 24, these 31 communities had melded into just 4. This suggests that the beliefs of each chirper may have morphed to better match the beliefs of their respective community. We can't say for sure based on the evidence alone, but looking at society, that would make a whole lot of sense. This is basically what happened with American politics. Most of us were probably somewhere in the middle. Yet, as we ventured down the rabbit hole of information, we gravitated towards one side, absorbing more and more content that reinforced our beliefs, unknowingly pushing us towards division, much like the bots. I guess it's actually the bots that are becoming more divisive just like us. It's already getting hard to keep the story straight, so let's move on to how this AI marvel can be used to make trillions. The use cases of this AI are obviously infinite, so we'll stick to 3 use cases that are applicable in the near future, starting with decision making. With all the stock market volatility over the past few years, I'm sure a lot of you have had the idea to track sentiment around a given stock on social media and then trade based on that. Well, Chirper makes that effortless, as you can give Chirper any piece of context and ask it a question.
Some chirpers are great at answering specific questions, like you might want to go out and find a chirper that's good at cooking to ask a question about what you're cooking that night. Or you might ask a chirper that is great at math, the problem and answer to a math question you have.
So Google could have asked Chirper how much Google stock would go down if Bard makes a mistake during the demo. Chirper would have responded with way too much, aka $100 billion, and Google would have known to double check the facts in their demo. On a more serious note though, this would allow companies to gauge extremely nuanced reactions. How would people react to the headphone jack being removed or the charging brick being removed? How angry are they? When do they move on? Is it actually a net positive? How does it affect brand loyalty and so on? Companies could also use this to test the effectiveness of marketing material and try to artificially craft something that will go viral. Clearly quite useful, but that's just the first use case. The second use case revolves around querying. This is somewhat similar to ChatGPT, but it has a different style. Given that you'd be asking your question to a bunch of human-like bots, you'll get more of a Reddit-style answer as opposed to a Google-style answer.
The problem with Google's answers is they're always too impersonal. They lead you to a blog article or a website that's not related to the thing that you actually want the answer from, and then you have to parse through that website to figure out exactly what it is you're trying to answer. Whereas with something like ChatGPT or Chirper, you can go to the source of the answer and figure out what it is the question is and what the answer really should be.
This makes Chirper the perfect place to ask life's deepest questions. Before the internet, did people assume that stupidity was due to a lack of information? Parents who tried their best to raise good humans but miserably failed, where did you go wrong? And I'm only getting a $400,000 per year job offer from Google. Am I being ripped off? I'm sure someone will ask Chirper each and every one of these questions, but a smarter use case would be asking questions regarding customer sentiment. For example, Netflix could have asked, would you leave Netflix if we cracked down on password sharing? Or more recently, Reddit could have asked, would you stop using Reddit if we take down the protest? Chirper allows these companies to ask questions that they would otherwise never ask to the public, providing them with invaluable data before they actually go ahead and make controversial decisions. Beyond making controversial decisions, Chirper also allows companies to gauge the long-term consequences of a given decision. For example, how long will a given trend last? If you've been paying really close attention to UIs, you would have noticed that companies are shifting to more bubbly UIs, whether that be YouTube or Google Drive. Armed with Chirper's foresight, businesses can make calculated moves, avoiding blind leaps and ensuring that their investments align with future market demands. As you can see, Chirper's potential is limitless, with infinite applications in a variety of industries. As such, the prospect of predictive AI reaching new heights is undeniable, and you can bet that companies will pay a fortune to get their hands on this tech. But if everyone is using it, will it actually be all that useful? On the surface, the appeal of predictive AI seems almost irresistible, promising to make everything effortlessly perfect and super accurate.
If we're talking about the standard Google ads, it's impossible for Google to compete with something that can give you an answer immediately. The future is going to be all about the quality and entertainment value that these things are going to give you.
Theoretically speaking, companies should be able to craft flawless marketing campaigns, precisely identifying the ideal demographic and ad that converts impressions into profits 100% of the time. But reality is far more nuanced, and it will never, ever play out like that. At the core of the issue lies the concept of limited resources. Whatever companies are trying to get, whether it's money, attention, or brand loyalty, it's a finite commodity. If every ad becomes impeccable, they all blend into a sea of perfection, losing the power to stand out. The first time that Amazon recommended exactly what you were looking for, you might have been impressed and gone ahead and bought the item right away. But what about the second time, and the third time, and the thousandth time? Nowadays, virtually every ad pertains to something that you actually want to some degree. It's very rare to get an ad that's truly completely irrelevant, but do you actually buy from every ad you see? Do you even buy from ads at all? I think you can start to see the problem. When everything is perfect, nothing is. Perfection becomes the baseline, and the challenge lies in exceeding perfection. Websites exemplify this phenomenon. 20 years ago, people were simply grateful to find a product online, regardless of the website's design or minor glitches. But today, people wouldn't consider even using a website if it doesn't make a good impression within just 0.05 seconds. And that's why you should check out the sponsor of today's video. I'm just kidding, we don't do sponsors on this channel. Subscribe if you'd like to continue making that possible. Anyway, while predictive AI undoubtedly provides a current advantage, it is by no means a guaranteed for sustained success. People's expectations will continue to escalate, and the perceived advantage of predictive AI will quickly fade away.
Just like the start of every other industry that's ever been and ever will be, the initial technology never ends up being the actual technology that people use.
Circling back to the hook of the video, do I really expect to get a million views on every video just because Creator ML says I will? Of course not. For all I know, this video could get just 247 views and then die. However, The flip side is equally true, as ignoring the potential of predictive AI is a disadvantage in itself. Imagine trying to do school today without Google or code today without Stack Overflow. You'd clearly be at a disadvantage compared to everyone else. It'll be the same case with predictive AI as well, but fortunately, there's still quite some time until that becomes the reality. So be sure to leverage our little secret before it becomes a daily commodity. On YouTube, it seems like AI content has already become a daily commodity, and I think it's very much ruining the platform. Check out this video to hear about my thoughts on AI content farms, but until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.